good afternoon, good night.
Feel the rays of your love. We feel the winds of your spirit.
Now
the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear.
God bless you as you tune in.
Feel the rays of your love. We feel the winds of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. We feel the rains of your love. We feel the wind of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. And let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. And let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven and let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven and let it rain.
Yeah.
Okay, God bless us, God bless us, God bless us. I hope everyone is having a wonderful time. I hope everyone is having a wonderful time. It's a beautiful Thursday afternoon in Canada, Calgary, Alberta. May the Lord bless you wherever you are viewing in from today. May the Lord bless you, may the Lord bless you, may the Lord bless you. Please, if you have not shared the broadcast, I want you to share the broadcast. If you have not invited your friend, I want you to go ahead and invite your friend. If you have not seen somebody in the presence of God, your brother, your sister that is supposed to be here and they are not here, I want you to go ahead and share. Call them up on the phone. Send to your friends on Messenger. Send to your friends on WhatsApp. Send to your friends on Facebook. Send to your friend on Instagram. Just invite people. Let them come to the presence of God. I thank God that has made it possible for us to gather again. I thank God that I haven't had any bad news. I thank God that they haven't had any emergency. I just want to bless the name of the Lord. So as you come in, tell me where you are. As you come in, tell me where you are viewing from. Tell me your location. Tell me your time zone. And you say, thank you, Jesus. So as you come in, you go ahead and say, thank you, Jesus. After thank you, Jesus, you tell me where you are viewing me from. After telling me where you are viewing me from, you tell me what time it is for you. And then you go ahead and share, and share, and share. God bless you.
Experience 2018. Theme, Amazing Glory. Featuring Abolo Furubel, Bura, Berebon, Hot, Badon, Power Melody, Faithful, Banuna, Sam, Daniel, Gift Banks, The Matt Socks, and Prince. Also ministering are G Melody, Bodo City Worship Experience Mass Choir, All Church Choir in Bodo City. Date, Friday 28th December 2018. Time, 9 p.m. prompt, all night. Venue, The Apostolic Church, Convention Arena, Bodo City, O'Connor, River State. For inquiries or support, please call 080-3744-7757 or 080-3255-6600. Powered by Generation Now Initiative. Pastor Dennis Connell, announcer.
Oh, open the floodgates. In abundance and call your name to fall. Open the floodgates in abundance and call.
Bye.
we need the rain. Ah, Lord, we need the rain, we need the rain. Holy Spirit, we need the rain, we need the rain. Oh, let it rain in our lives, let it rain, let it rain. In everything, Lord, let it rain, let it rain. Oh, let it rain. Oh, let it rain. I know you guys swim. I know you guys were really enjoying the watch party. And I paused the watch party. We are going to continue with the watch party later in the night. So please, for now, go ahead and share the broadcast for us to start.
Thank you, Lord.
Because I see that the time favors everybody. So what's going on?
Hosanna.
Oh,
qué? God bless all of us. God bless everyone. God bless you for tuning in today. Happy Thursday to you wherever you're watching me from. I know that some people are already in their Fridays. Some people is already 1 a.m. for them from the time zone I'm seeing. Some people, they are still in their Thursday. The Lord has done so much for us that we cannot tell it all. The Lord has been so faithful. God is not like a man. God is not like a man. You tell something to a friend. You tell something to a neighbor. You tell something to your colleague. You tell something to your husband. You tell something to the church. You tell something to the people. They go and they let out the thing which you didn't expect them to. But when you tell your problems to God, God keeps it to himself. It is preserved. It is secure. And it is intact. That's the kind of God that we have come to reference today. That's the one that we are coming to give thanks to. That is the one that we are singing Hosanna to. That's the one we are saying, may your name be lifted high. Hosanna. That's the one we are waving our hands to. That's the one we have come in gratitude, in worship for. The one who can never leak our secret out. The one who can never make us feel bad. The one who can never make us feel less. The one who appreciates, the one who cares, the one who honors, and the one who pampers and pets us in every situation. It's that God that we are coming to save and worship. May his mighty name be glorified. So I just want you to go ahead and share the broadcast. If you haven't shared the broadcast, I want you to share the broadcast. After you have shared the broadcast, I want you to tell Jesus, thank you. I want you to have a reason to be grateful to God. The Lord has preserved your life from Monday to Thursday. You have gone out and you have come in. The same road that you went out and people had accidents is the same road you have been applying and you have not gotten accidents. The same car you are riding and people are having themselves batch up here and there is the same car that you have entered. The same train that had an accident is the same you applied on your way going and your way coming back, but the Lord did not allow any evil to befall you. The same job you did and you got fired is the same job that other people did and they are not in it. The same job that you're preserving is the same that somebody got fired from. The same marriage you got into is the same that somebody is having a divorce and has walked out of. The same relationship you have is the same that somebody has and it's not working for them. The same marriage you got into when you are still holding on tight onto yours and it's not working for others is the same that others had. The same business you went into when others are not making profit but you are making profit is the same business that everybody went into. The same marriage you went into and you are fruitful is the same one that people went into and they are not fruitful. The same school that you got into and other people are not graduating but you have graduated is the same school, is the same admission that they had. The same way that others have not had or nothing on their table is the same way the Lord has provided for you. So I want you to have a reason in your heart to tell the Lord this evening, to tell the Lord this afternoon, to tell the Lord this morning, to tell the Lord this night, no matter your time zone, you just want to tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. I just want you to say, thank you, Jesus. I just want you to tell the Lord, thank you, Jesus. So many people have died of diabetes. So many people have died of depression. So many people have died of anger. So many people have committed suicide because of one trouble or the other. So many people have killed themselves because of frustration. So many people have gotten themselves into trouble because of running their mouth. So many people have gotten so many things happen to them because of one thing or the other. But look at you, you are still standing. Look at you, you are still alive. Look at you. Whatever it is that is sending people to the hospital is not sending you to the hospital. Whatever it is that is chasing people at night is not chasing you at night. Whatever it is that is not allowing people to have peace is not applying it to you. So you gotta tell the Lord, thank you. It is not because you're worthy. It is not because you're righteous. It is not because you're pure. It is not because you're holy. It is not because you know how to cross the road. It is not because you know how to tie your mouth. It is not because you are the best in that office. It is not because you are the best in that marriage. It is not because you were born with kids in your womb. That is the reason God is blessing you with the fruit of the womb. No, but the mercies of the Lord endure it forever. That is the reason. So you gotta have a reason to be thankful to God. I just want you to go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you. I just want you to go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you. I just want you to go ahead and tell the Lord, thank you. That you did not wake up in the hospital bed this morning, you're going to tell the Lord, thank you. That you ate something and you did not go down on food poisoning, you have to tell the Lord, thank you. That you woke up in that marriage and you saw your children hell and hate it, you got to tell the Lord, thank you. It is not by your making. It is not by your power. It is not by your might. But it's by the precious hand of God that has preserved you and has kept you. It is because the Lord has been okay to keep his covenant with you. It is because the Lord has promised that he will not fail you. Neither will he forsake you like the comfortless. That is why the Lord has kept to his own side of promise. It is not because you are worthy. It is not because you are righteous. It is not because you are better than any other person. It is because the Lord has preserved you. The same car you drove from Monday till Thursday is the same car that is not having an accident. People got on the road and they did not come back safe. The same car that people went on a journey, they came out alive, and some people had the same accident and they died at the spot. On Sunday, you people saw what befell my son. He was involved in a car accident. The car was totally damaged, but seed spoke for him. Seed spoke for him. Seed spoke for him. You gotta have something to hold God onto. You gotta have something to hold God onto and tell the Lord, Father, it is not because I am righteous. It is not because I am perfect. It is not because I deserve it. It is not because I am careful, but it is because you love me. It is because you have decided to keep your covenant with me. People have businesses. They go out for their businesses. They cannot make sales. People are working without benefits. People don't even have insurance to cover up for their debt and their finances. People got no money to pay school fees. People are lonely. But if the Lord has taken care of you, if the Lord has preserved you in one way or the other, if you're still standing, it is not because you deserve it. It is not because you are good. It is not because you have been doing so many things. That is why you're still standing. It is by the grace of God. It is by the grace of God. There are some people who were not even as sick as you were. They were gone. Some people just got down on headache, and that's the end of their story. I want you to tell the Lord, thank you. I want you to tell the Lord, thank you. I just want you to tell the Lord, Father, thank you. Because I did not been for you, I will not be sitting right here. Had it not been for you, I will not be speaking right now. Had it not been for you, if it has not been for you, Jesus, my enemies would have consumed me. If it has not been for you, Jesus, my enemies would have triumphed over me. If it has not been for you, Lord, my grave would have been growing grasses now. If it has not been for you, Lord, my enemies will be rejoicing right now. If it has not been for you, Lord, my hands would have been on my head right now. If it has not been for you right now, they would have been laughing at me right now. People have been teasing me right now. Maybe my ministry would have fallen up right now. Maybe your marriages would have fallen up right now. Maybe your children would have been dead right now. Maybe your job would have been gone right now. Maybe your business would have been folded right now. Maybe your relationship would have been gone right now. If it has not been for the Lord, so many things will not have happened for you. If it has not been for the Lord, you will not be breathing right now. If it has not been for the Lord, probably you would have been sent back home. If it has not been for the Lord, probably you will have no clothes to wear. If it has not been for the Lord, probably you will have no food to eat. If it has not been for the Lord,
Probably you would have been long forgotten. If it has not been for the Lord, your houses would have been under struggle now. Probably if it has not been for the Lord, Rama sense the bosque, yeah. You gotta be have a reason to be grateful to God. If it has not been for the Lord, probably people would have been coming for your car right now. People would have been claiming your wealth in the bank. People would have been claiming your money right now. People would have been struggling with your children right now. People would have been going over your possession right now. People would have been struggling your land right now. Do you know how many battles that was thrown to you overnight and the Lord made you to escape? Do you know how many unseen battles that the Lord has fought for you? Do you know how many captivity you have won because of the Lord? Do you know how many times the Lord has made your enemies to hide and peep at you? Because they feel that by now your life should be gone. But the Lord turned the negativity of your enemies into positivity for you. Do you know how many times the people felt that by this time this year that they will be standing at your funeral and they will be singing for you? Do you know how many people want to put on their black garments just to come and do as if they are mourning you? Meanwhile, they are celebrating your death. Do you know how many people are not happy for your laughter? Do you know how many people are not happy for your love buttons? Do you know how many people are not happy for your share button? Do you know how many people are not happy just seeing your name? Do you know how many people are not happy for your success? Do you know how many people are not happy for your beauty? Do you know how many people are not happy for your existence? Do you know? How many people are not happy for your existence? Your existence on earth is annoying to somebody. Your voice alone is irritating to somebody. And people don't want to hear the scent of their perfume. People don't want to see you pass by. People don't want to see you drive that car. People don't want to see you pay that rent. People want you to come begging with plate and telling them, can I have something to eat? They are not truly happy for you. Because that was not their plan initially. They thought that by now, you should be crying, you should be mourning, you should be borrowing, you should be weeping, you should be lamenting, you should be sent packing back home, you should be deported, that document should not come true, that business proposal should not come true. But the Lord did not only expose them, the Lord thwarted their evil plans. The Lord thwarted their evil plans. The Lord did not just allow them to sit there and plan the evil. The Lord is allowing them to stay and see him prosper you. The Lord is allowing them to see and see them renew your morning. He says they are new every morning. He says they are new every morning. Praise is his holy name. Praise is the living God. For every new morning that you see, life is a gift to you. People are in the hospital bed right now. They cannot buy oxygen. People are in the mortuary right now. They are wishing that they had all the money to buy life. They would have bought life for themselves, but they cannot buy life. That's why they are lying there lifeless. There are so many grown people, influential people, dependent people in the society, but they couldn't buy lives for themselves. And here you are. The Lord has given you life free of charge. The Lord has given you life irrespective of who you are. The Lord has preserved you over your enemies. The Lord is not allowing every blood-sucking demon to suck your blood. The Lord is not allowing the people that are angry over your success to triumph over you. The Lord is not allowing the evil plans of the enemies to come to pass. The Lord is not allowing the manipulation of the enemies to triumph over their plans. The Lord did not allow them to knock the door and pull you out. The Lord did not allow them to lift your face on the road and begin to check your pocket for ID cards. The Lord did not allow them to make a phone call to your family that you are on the road. The Lord did not allow you to involve in that classic accident. The Lord did not allow your death to be raised in the face. The Lord did not allow you to wake up and find yourself in prison. The Lord did not allow you to go to places that you were not supposed to find yourself. The Lord did not allow them to come and say to you, sister, sorry. The Lord did not allow them to come to you and say, brother, sorry. The Lord did not allow them to come and sympathize with you. The Lord did not allow them to come and say, how did it happen? The Lord did not allow them to sign the registry and say, we came to mourn with you. The Lord did not allow your enemies to sit down and hear the evil story over your life. That is the God that we have come to worship. The one who has given our enemies shame in return. The one who has not allowed the door of this ministry to be shut. The one who has not allowed us not to host this live broadcast because of all the manipulation from the pit of hell. The one who has not allowed it to be because of man that we are not standing. The one who has not allowed you to call and say, Mommy, what is happening that you are not coming live anymore? We are coming to worship the Lord who has put the plans of the enemies in their mockery. We are coming to worship the one who would disgrace the enemies openly. We are coming to worship the God who knows the beginning from the end. We are coming to worship the God who has given us victory over every situation. You don't know what they plan in your marriage. You don't know what they plan in your business. You don't know what they plan in the life of your children. You don't know what they plan to the life of your friends. You know what they plan in the life of their viewers. You don't know what they plan over this broadcast. You don't know what they plan in every business of us. You don't know what they plan in your going out and your coming in. You don't know what they plan in every evil thing. You don't know what they plot. You don't know what the plot of the enemy was. But the Lord disappointed them. The Lord will give your tears to your enemies to drink in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give your mockery to your enemies to eat in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give your shame to your enemies to eat in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give your cry to your enemies to cry in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give your sadness to your enemies in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give your frustrations to your enemies in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give your disappointment to your enemies in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give your disgrace to your enemies in the name of Jesus. The Lord will disgrace them in their going out and their coming in. They will never know peace in this life unless the Lord does not live. But as long as the Lord lives, your enemies will know no peace. Your afflictors will know no peace. Anybody that is sitting on your success will die for you to prosper. Anybody that wants you to go, the Lord will let them go for you. Anybody that wants you dead, the Lord will kill them on your behalf. Anybody that wants you to go, the Lord will kill them on your behalf. Anybody that wants you to stay in affliction, affliction of the Lord shall oppress them. Anybody that is against you, I send the fire of the Holy Ghost to be against them in the name of Jesus. Anybody that is against your success, may the Lord be against their success. Anybody that is standing against your progress, may the Lord stand against their progress. Anybody that is the reason for your tears, may the Lord give them tears to cry. Anyone that knows the reason why you are not prospering, may the Lord allow them to stay in poverty for the rest of their life. Ida Masiki. Today I have come because I am provoking my spirit. Enough is enough. Whoever says that you cannot see better days, may the Lord give all the days of your sadness to them in thousandfold in the name of Jesus. Whoever says your children shall not do well academically, may the Lord give them foolishness to their generation. Whoever says you will not be promoted in your job, may the Lord give them failures for their breakfast, failures for their lunch, failures for their supper. They shall weep throughout the rest of their life. They will know no peace until the Lord lives. Except the Lord liveth, your enemies will never go unpunished. Except the Lord liveth, your enemies will never go unpunished. Whoever is the reason why you have been having sleepless nights, whoever is the reason why you have been afflicted in your dream, whoever is the reason why you are snatching your teeth morning to night, whoever is the evil one that is stealing your finances, every evil cat, every evil dog, every evil woman, every evil man, every evil child, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Whoever says that you will not have peace in the land of the living, whoever has covenanted that except they die, better things will not come your way, may the Lord kill them for you to see better days in the name of Jesus. Whoever has covenanted that this broadcast will not hold, may the Lord not allow your life to hold in the name of Jesus. Whoever is angry for the gospel, may the anger of the Lord locate them in the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever is against the gospel, may the Lord be against them in the name of Jesus. Whoever is against the Lord, may the Lord be against them in the name of Jesus. Whoever is against the gospel of the Lord, may the Lord be against their marriage. May the Lord be against their relationship. May the Lord be against their ministry. May the Lord be against their health. May the Lord be against their healing. May the Lord be against everything they touch their hands to do in this life. They will never know peace. They will never know no peace. If I be a woman of God, I render them with madness today in the name of Jesus. Whoever says, I am out to afflict the children of God, today I release the host of angels to be out on their cases in the name of Jesus. Today I release the host of heavens to be out on their cases in the mighty name of Jesus. Today I release the host of heavens to be out on their cases in the mighty name of Jesus. From today henceforth, anger shall locate them. Even in their marriages, your husband will be angry with them. Your wives will be angry with them. Your children will be angry with them. Your community will be angry with them. The devil will be angry with them. Jesus shall be angry with them. I give them anger to drink as water in the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever it is that has ever released angry button on the gospel of the Lord on this broadcast, I release the anger of the Lord to afflict you for the rest of your life. Whoever it is that has ever stood against the gospel of God on this broadcast, I release the anger of the Lord on you on the mighty name of Jesus. I release the flaming fire of the Holy Ghost over you. You will feel hurt in your life that you have never seen before. You will go to hospitals, you will not find healing. You will run mad on the street and you will tell people, yeah, truly I was against the children of God and they cast me. You will never know better days in your life. Affliction shall affect you in the morning. Affliction shall arise for you in the afternoon. Affliction shall locate you over the days of your life, until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so shall it be. Whoever is the reason why you are lying down in your bed and you cannot sleep at night, whoever is the reason why you eat and you don't feel full, whoever is the reason why you sit down and you do not have joy in your heart, whoever is responsible for anything that is going on in your life, whoever is responsible for the things that you're going through, whoever is responsible to the breakthrough power of Jesus in your life, whoever is responsible to your happiness on earth, may the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. Accident shall be their portion. Bad luck shall be their portion. Sickness shall be their portion. Illness shall be their portion. Disappointment shall be their portion. Sack from work shall be their portion. Lack of peace shall be their portion. Lack of sleep shall be their portion. They will never know better days in the mighty name of Jesus. Enough is enough. Whoever is the reason why you cannot have your document, wherever you are in any part of the world, in any country where you are, you have been in a country for 5 years, you have been in a country for 2 years, you have been in a country for 1 year, you have been in a country for 6 months, you are due for your citizenship, you are due for your permanent residence, you are due for your work permit, you are due for any pretensions that you need, but they are not sitting on it, they are not lifting their butt so that your success can come true. May the Lord lift them in the name of Jesus. If they don't want to lift by force, may the Lord lift them by fire. If they don't want to lift by will, may the Lord lift them by fire. If they don't want to lift by will, may the Lord lift them by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Anybody that is responsible for the reason you cannot get a job, anybody that is sitting on your success, anybody that is sitting on your breakthrough, anybody that is sitting on your job opportunity, anybody that is sitting on your promotion, anybody that is sitting on your success, may the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. I relocate your work to locate you in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bring your job to locate you in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bring your job to locate you in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bring your love to locate you in the name of Jesus. Whoever says you will not have a job in this life, may the Lord regress them in the name of Jesus. Whoever says that you will not have a job in this life, may the Lord take their jobs and give you in the name of Jesus. Whoever is responsible for the reason why you are jobless, may they die in the name of Jesus. Whoever is sitting on your job opportunity, may they die in the name of Jesus. Whoever is sitting on your job opportunity, may they die in the name of Jesus. Whoever is sitting on your job opportunity, may they die in the name of Jesus. Whoever is sitting in your job opportunity, may they die in the name of Jesus. Some of you, you have gone into marriage. You have gone into people's home. Marriage was to be enjoyed, not to be endured. Tell the Lord, any evil woman that is sitting on my marriage, any evil woman that has vowed that I will not enjoy my marriage, any evil man, any evil child, wherever they are, that they have vowed in their hearts that I would not enjoy my marriage, that I will not make forth from this marriage, that I will not break forth from my marriage, may the Lord disgrace them, may the Lord kill them, may the Lord uplift them, may the Lord raise them, may the Lord fire them, may the Lord kill them, may the Lord disgrace them, may the Lord give them accident in their portion. Whoever is the reason why your marriage is not working, whoever is the reason that they have carried your marriage to the enemy's camp, whoever has carried your home to the camp of the enemies, and they begin to afflict your marriage, and there is so much tension in your marriage, and there is so much fire in your marriage, and there is so much heat in your marriage, you cannot have peace in your marriage. May the Lord disgrace them. May the Lord disgrace them. May the Lord cut them over. 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 May the Lord cut them off. I release the acts of God from heaven, and I begin to destroy every enemy who is sitting on your marriage. I cut them in the name of God the Father. I cut them in the name of God the Son. I disgrace them. I scatter them. I cut them up into pieces. They shall die by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. They shall die by fire. Disgrace shall locate them. Death shall be their portion. Rest shall be their portion. Wrath shall be their portion. Poverty shall be their portion. Wretchedness shall be their portion. Sickness shall be their portion. Every evil covenant on earth that the Lord vows to keep those who are not of him will locate them in Jesus' name. The Bible says, suffer not the witch to die. Now you are going to say, every evil witch, every evil mother, every evil father, every evil sister, every evil friend, every evil uncle, every evil auntie, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every witches and wizard that are operating your destiny, that are operating your lives, that are attacking your destiny, that are not allowing things to be good for you. Any witches or wizard, any occultic power, any power from the shrine, every man-made water spirit, every power from the darkness, every power of the witches, the one from the spirit world, the one from the darkness, the one from the evil, the one from the shrine, the one from the juju priest, God punish them. Let devil die. Let devil die. Let devil die. Tell the Lord to punish your devil. Tell the Lord to punish the devil. Tell the Lord to afflict them with sickness. Tell the Lord to afflict them with madness. They must die for you to prosper. They must die for you to do exploit. They must die for you to break forth. They must die for your glory to come. They must die for the will of God to work in your life. Every evil friend, every evil auntie, every evil uncle, every evil friend, every monitoring spirit, every evil pastor, every evil woman, any evil prophet, any evil person that is standing against your progress, may the Lord kill them in the mighty name of Jesus. Nobody is exempted. Whether you are a child and you are evil, you will die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Whether you are a prophet and you are evil, you will die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Whether you are a woman of God and you are using the name of God to afflict the children of God, may the Lord kill you in the name of Jesus. Whether you are a man of God and you are using the name of God to afflict the children of God, may the Lord kill you in the name of Jesus. Whether you are the mother, whether you are the father, whether you are the sibling, whether you are the auntie, whether you are the uncle, and you are not ready to see the prosperity of the children of God, may the Lord kill you in the name of Jesus. You must die. You must die. The wrath of the Lord is reaching you. Whether you like it or not, you will accept defeat and die. Whether you accept it or not, you will face deceit and you will die. You cannot continue. You cannot continue to operate in a lane where God did not call you. You cannot continue to afflict people down. You cannot continue to put the lives of people in danger. You cannot continue to use the gospel to fool people. You cannot continue to put affliction in the realms of the children of God. You cannot continue to put manipulation over the children of God. Anybody, man or woman, that is putting manipulation over your life, that is covering you with something that you cannot know the truth, that is covering your eyes with power so that you don't know the truth, anybody that is using evil deliverance to rather put you into shame, to rather put you into their camp, to rather put you in their cage, to put you in their captivity, I raise you up from captivity of the enemies in the name of Jesus. I break you from the captivity of the enemy in the name of Jesus. You shall not stay in that cage. I break you from that cage of the enemy in the name of Jesus. Every evil person, be it a child, be it a man, be it a woman, be it a prophet, be it a pastor, anybody who is responsible for the reason why things are not working for you, I say what? Enough is enough. They must die for you to prosper. They cannot continue to hide under coverage, to afflict the children of God, to afflict the anointed of God, to lie and cover your eyes from the truth. From today, I break you off that cage in the mighty name of Jesus. I break you over the cage from the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. I untie your eye for your eye to be open for you to know the truth. Every spell that was cast upon your life, I break that spell in the name of Jesus. Every spell that you ate in your dream, I break that evil spell in the name of Jesus. Every spell that was poured on you, I break that spell in the name of Jesus. Every spell that was covering your spiritual eyes, I break it forth in the name of Jesus. I scatter their spell in the name of Jesus. I scatter their spell in the name of Jesus. I destroy their spell in the name of Jesus. I destroy their spell in the name of Jesus. It shall not stand, the Bible says, neither will it come to pass. Whether they like it or not, they will accept defeat and die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Unless the Lord is not on the throne. But if the Lord liveth on the throne, they shall accept defeat and die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Now you're going to tell the Lord, then whatever it is that is afflicting my body with sickness, whatever it is that has made me to spend money in hospitals, whatever sickness, disease, infirmity that is in my body, that the doctors have called for names, that I have gone around looking for cures and solutions and I cannot find, every evil sickness in my body, Lord, heal me in the name of Jesus. Every evil sickness in my body, Lord, heal me in the name of Jesus. Every evil sickness in my body, Lord, be it HIV, be it cancer, be it depression, be it hypertension, be it high blood, be it arthritis, be it cancer, be it fibroid, whatever sickness is in my body that I am spending money from head to toe, that I have been spending money since I was born, that I am living on medication, that I have gone so many places for solution, but I cannot find solution, Lord. Today I come before you, Lord, because you are the healer, Lord. Because you are the healer, Lord. Because you are the healer, Lord. You say you will heal me. You will say you will heal my disease. You say you will heal my infirmity. You say by my stripes that you are healed. Father, in the name of Jesus, come and heal your children of any disease, Lord. Of any disease, Lord. Of any infirmity, Lord. Of every virus, Lord. Of every stress of cancer. Of everything that is moving in the bloodstream, Lord. Everything that is moving in our bloodstream, Lord. Everything that is moving in our cells, Lord. Everything that is moving in our blood, Lord. Everything that is moving in our body, Lord. Physically and spiritually, destroy the sickness in the name of Jesus. Every sickness in our body, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every sickness that is in our body, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every sickness that is in our body, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every sickness that is in our body, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every sickness that is in our body, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every sickness that is in our body, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every sickness that is in our body, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. I don't care to know where they came from. I don't care to know how long they have been in your body. I don't care to know the results of the earth doctors. I am not even interested about the finances of the devil. I am not even afraid of the tricks of the devil. I don't even care about the results that the doctor gave at the hospital. I am speaking with the power that is upon my life. If the Lord liveth in his throne right now, every sickness in your body dies right now. Every sickness in your body dies right now. There is no sickness for your body again. There is no sickness in your body again. I cause every sickness to pack their loads and disappear. I cause every sickness to pack their loads and go. I cause every sickness to pack their loads and go. I cause every sickness to pack their loads and go. I cause every sickness to pack their loads and disappear. You sickness of the pit of hell. You sickness from the pit of hell. You sickness from the pit of mammy water. You sickness from the pit of the witches. You sickness from anywhere that you came from. The one that was blown in the hay. The one that you hate in your dream. The one that you drank through water. The one that you went to places and they touched you and put it in you. The one that you don't know how he came into your body. May they disappear in the name of Jesus. 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 Every sickness that is not of God, that is in your body, may they die right now in the name of Jesus. The Bible speaking says, affliction shall not arise the second time. When the Lord heals, he heals completely. It says, whom it pleases the Lord to show mercy, the Lord shows mercy. Whom it pleases the Lord to show honor, the Lord shows honor. Whatever it is that pleases the Lord to do, the Lord does it. Every evil sickness that was in your body, the one that walks within the night, the one that comes in the morning, the one that comes in the afternoon, the one that comes weekly, the one that comes monthly, the one that comes yearly, the one that is biting you right now as I'm talking, I destroy them and I kill them to die by the power of the Holy Ghost. Every evil sickness in your body surrenders to the power of the Lord Almighty right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now we are going to tell the Lord. Some of you, you are due for marriage. Sometimes you need to get provoke in your spirit and pray. Until you get provoked in your spirit, the devil does not know peace. Until you get provoked in your spirit, the devil is not a gentleman. Don't be a gentleman for the devil. Don't be a gentle lady for the devil. Attack the devil. The Bible says we wrestle against principalities and powers in high places. Don't spare the devil. God punish devil. The devil is a bastard. The devil is an idiot. The devil is a loser. The devil is not authority to oppress you. So you got to take your stand in God and tell the devil enough is enough. I am not moved by your angry face. I am not moved by your stupidity, because that is stupidity that you're displacing there. I don't have time for your BS anymore. It is time to fight you spiritually and otherwise. It is time for me to release the fire of the Lord upon you. I don't have time for your drama, because you come just like the Bible says. The devil does not come if not to steal, if not to kill, if not to destroy. So when you see the devil, don't be gentle with the devil. Otherwise the devil strikes you down, because the devil does not come if not to steal, to kill and to destroy. The devil is not your friend. The devil is not coming to make peace with you. Don't give yourself to the devil. Otherwise, they will destroy you. Because he's not a gentleman. He is not a gentle lady. The devil is a bastard. The devil is an idiot. The devil is a loser. That is why they remove their angry faces. Because that is their frustration. The angry faces is their frustration. Because if they were not stupid, then they will come and fight physically. That is to show you that the scripture is real. That is their stupidity that they are displacing. The devil does not come in the physical. He comes in the spiritual like that. The devil hides and fights the battle. The devil can be your friend. The devil can be your pastor. The devil can be your neighbor. The devil can be your next door friend. The devil can be your best friend. There is no gentleman in Christ. You gotta be aggressive. The Bible says right from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violent, and the violent taken it by force. You got no time to be gentle with the devil. You got no time to play peace with the devil. You got no time to be friends with the devil. You got no time to talk gentle with the devil. Give it to the devil the way he is, because he's a bastard. Give it to the devil the way he is, because he's an idiot. Give it to the devil the way he is, because he's a loser. Give it to the devil the way he is, because he's an idiot. The devil is not coming to make peace with you. The devil is not coming to be friends with you. The devil is coming to fight. The devil is coming to steal. The devil is coming to ruin you. So you gotta be alert and fight the devil. You don't have time to play with the devil. You don't have time to be friends with the devil. You don't have time to negotiate with the devil because he's an idiot. He lost 2,000 years ago and he will continue to lose. The devil must accept defeat. Whether the devil likes it or not, the devil must accept defeat because he was defeated years back. But yet he still fights. Why is he still fighting? Why is she still fighting? Because she does not have common sense. The devil does not want to accept defeat. That Jesus defeated me. Let me find my place and stay. No. They come in disguise of your friends. They come in disguise of your relatives. They come in disguise of your neighbors. They come in disguise of your colleagues to come and afflict you. So you have to be prayerful. To know when the devil is coming through your mom. To know when the devil is coming through your father. To know when the devil is coming through your neighbor. To know when the devil is coming through the church. To know when the devil is right here. You gotta be violent. You don't gotta do gentle for the devil. You have reached the age of marriage. And the devil is fighting it. Because that from time, that was what the devil was fighting, marriage. The devil is not happy when people are celebrating. The devil is not happy when people are rejoicing. The devil is not happy when people have a better reunion. That is why the devil fights marriage. Right now, you're going to tell the Lord. Any devil, be it principalities and powers, from the pit of hell, that is fighting my marriage, that is fighting my relationship, that is fighting my happiness, that is fighting my breakthrough, that is fighting my testimony. May the Lord disgrace them. 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 In the name of Jesus. They will sense and they will hear the goodness and that which the Lord has done for you. Whatever the Lord has done for his children in this service, it shall be permanent. Whatever the Lord has given to you in this service, it shall be permanent. Whatever the Lord has given to you in this service, I said it shall be permanent. Whatever the Lord has released for you in this service, it shall be permanent. Whatever the Lord has released for you in this speech, it shall be permanent. Now you're going to tell the Lord, Father, wherever my blessing in life escaped, wherever my success in life escaped, wherever my testimony in life escaped, Father, I want you to go and bring them back for me. Every power that is working at night does not have power over my blessings. Every power that is working during the day does not have power over my breakthrough. Every power that is working in the morning does not have power over the testimony that God has given to me. Wherever my blessing in life has been kept, wherever my breakthrough testimony in life has been kept, wherever the good things that the Lord kept for me in life has been tied, every power that is working in the night, every power that is working in the day, every power that is working in the morning, every evil power of the enemy that is going round the clock to afflict me with my success, with my blessing, with my testimony, may the Lord locate them to die. And may the Lord go and bring my testimony for me. In the name of Jesus. May the Lord go and bring your testimonies for you. In the name of Jesus. May the Lord go and bring your testimony for you. In the name of Jesus. May the Lord go and bring your testimony for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord go and bring your testimony for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Whoever says that you will not live to declare the goodness of the Lord, may the Lord kill them on your behalf. Whoever says that you will not live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living, whoever has eaten his heart, whoever has eaten her heart, whoever has declared, be it a man or a woman, be it a prophet or a servant of God, be it a friend or a neighbor, whoever has declared in their heart that the promises, that the goodness of the Lord, that you will not see it in the land of the living, may the Lord kill them by his rock. May the Lord kill them by his axe. May the Lord scatter their brain with his hammer. May the catapult enemy of the enemy crush them down in the name of Jesus. May the caterpillar of heaven crush them to ashes in the name of Jesus. May the caterpillar of heaven crush them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord crush them in the name of Jesus. Every evil snake, every evil serpent, every evil snake, every evil cobra that is swallowing my fortune, that is swallowing my breakthrough, that is swallowing my finances, that is sitting on my wealth, may the Lord kill you today in the name of Jesus. May the Lord scatter you in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy you in the name of Jesus. May the fire of the Holy Ghost smoke on your roof in the name of Jesus. Every evil cobra, every evil snake, a gamma lizard from the pit of darkness that is swallowing the wealth of the children of God, that is swallowing the finances of the children of God, that they are opening their wealth to swallow your finances, that are taking your money from wherever they are seeing it from, may the Lord God Almighty kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord scatter them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord crush their heads in the name of Jesus. May the Lord crush their heads in the name of Jesus. May the Lord crush their head in the name of Jesus. They will go to sleep and they will never wake up again. They will go to sleep. They will never wake up again. They will go to sleep. They will never wake up again. Curses shall be their portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Anybody who has ever given you pain in one way or the other, anybody who has ever given you pain in one way or the other, anybody who has ever been the reason why you have shed tears, anyone who has ever been the reason why you are lamenting today, anyone who has ever been the reason why things are not working for you, may the Lord fill their cup with tears and give them to drink. May the Lord fill your tears in a cup and give them to drink. May the Lord give them the sorrows of your life for them to carry in the name of Jesus. May the Lord give them all the disgrace that has befallen you right from when you were born to this very time. May the Lord give them in the mighty name of Jesus. Every agony of your life, may the Lord give it to your enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. Every agony of your life, may the Lord give it to your enemies. Every agony of your life, may the Lord give it to your enemies. Every sadness of your life, may the Lord give it to your enemy. Every affliction of your life, may the Lord give it to your enemy. Every manipulation of your life, may the Lord give it to your enemies. From today henceforth, your enemies are carrying everything that you were carrying. Every bondage of your life, your enemies carry them today. Every sadness of your life, your enemies carry them today. Every affliction of your life, your enemies carry them today. Whether they like it or not, today the Lord has given it to them. Every basket of evil that they planted for you, that they harvested for you, today the Lord is giving it back to them. It is time for vengeance. The 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 time for vengeance is now. The Lord is giving them. Every affliction of your life, every failure of your life, every sadness of your life, every tears of your life, every backwardness, every disappointment, every sickness of your life, today your enemies carry them in the name of Jesus. Enough, I say, is enough. Enough is enough. Whoever has ever been responsible for the reason why you did not make it, whoever was the reason why you lose that job, whoever was the reason why you did not take it, whoever was the reason why you are suffering in that marriage, whoever is the reason why your house is on fire, whoever is the reason why your ministry is on fire, whoever is the reason why your children are on fire, whoever is the reason why your job is on fire, whoever is the reason why your career is on fire, whoever is the reason why your home is on fire, whoever is the reason why things are not happening to you, every evil thing that happened in your life, today the Lord is reversing it. and is giving it to your enemy. You are free in the name of Jesus. 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 Whether the enemy likes it or not, whether the generation power likes it or not, whether the foundation power likes it or not, whether the lineage power likes it or not, whether the church power likes it or not, whether your friend likes it or not, whether the people likes it or not, whether your neighbors likes it or not, today the Lord is bringing you salvation. The Lord is setting you free from captivity. The Lord is setting you free from stagnation. The Lord is setting you free from your sickness. The Lord is setting you free from the pothole of the enemy. The Lord is setting you free from wherever you were tied. Whether they tied you to a chain, whether they tied you to a tree, whether they tied you to a goat, whether they tied you to the floor, whether they tied you to a fly, whether they locked you in the house, today the agonies of your life, the Lord is giving it to your enemies in the name of Jesus. Every agony of your life, every agony of your life, every agony of your life, in any way, in your career, in your marriage, in your relationship, in your defense, in your education, in your promotion, in your home, in the life of your children, in your generation, in your lineage, in your family, in your wherever, even in your ministry, even on this broadcast, every agony in the life of every viewers, every agony in the life of people in Heaven Chapel Foundation International, every agony of your grand, the ones that died and the Lord did not revenge, I said today is the day of vengeance. May the Lord avenge for you. May the Lord avenge for you. Because of you, somebody will go down. Because of you, somebody would die today. Because of you, somebody would confess today. Because of you, somebody would know no peace. Because of you, somebody would die young. Because of you, somebody is taking that sickness. Because of you, I see the Lord replacing you with them in the name of Jesus. I see the Lord replacing you with them in the name of Jesus. Since they said it is good to cry, may the Lord give them tears to cry. Since they say it is good to stay in sadness, may the Lord give them sadness. Since they say it is good to be angry, may the Lord give them anger. Since they say it is good to be barren, may the Lord make them barren. Since they say it is good to be lifeless, may the Lord kill them. May the Lord give them no peace. May the Lord give them no breakthrough. From today henceforth, their ways are locked. Their lives are locked. Their breakthrough is locked. Their marriage are locked. Their relationship are locked. Their ministry are locked. Their going out is locked. Nothing shall work for them. They shall be demoted. They shall be demoted. Accident shall be their portion. Death shall be their portion. Death shall be their portion. Untimely death is their portion. Hunger is their portion. Sickness is their portion. They will die in the name of Jesus. Whoever is sitting, enough is enough. Whoever is sitting on your breakthrough, whoever is carrying hand and laughing while things are not happening, whoever is coming to you as a wicked friend, every agent of darkness, every evil spies, every monitoring spirit, every power of darkness, every power from the pit of hell, the one from the Son of Man, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. 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 Today I release the matches from heaven. And I destroy you in the name of God the Father. I matchet you in the name of God the Son. I matchet you in the name of God the Holy Spirit. I matchet you in the name of God the Holy Spirit. You will never rise again throughout your lifetime. Unless there is no God in heaven. Enough is enough. Whoever is responsible, whoever has even sat at the place where they are planning it, whoever even conceived it, whoever gave one idea or the other, whoever supported any evil against you, today the wrath of the Lord meets them. Today the arrow of the Lord meets them. Today the anger of the Lord meets them. Affliction shall afflict them day in, day out. They will never know peace. They will never see the face of the Lord. They will never see the goodness of the Lord. Sadness shall locate them. Whatever they touch on earth to do, it will never spring forth. Whatever they lay their hands to do, it will never spring result. Wherever they enter, the anger of the Lord shall locate them. Wherever they drive to, they shall meet with accidents. Whatever door they open, it shall be closed unto them. Whatever they touch, it shall be destroyed before them. Wherever they go, people shall gang up against them. Wherever they enter, the earth shall regress them. Whatever it is that their eyes sees, it shall be evil. Whatever their hand touches, fire shall spring forth. From today henceforth, I release storm with your enemy. From today henceforth, I wage war with your enemies. From today henceforth, I release the arrow of God over your enemies. From today henceforth, the cry of your enemies will be heard in the nation. From today henceforth, your enemies will know no sleep. From today henceforth, your enemies will know no rest. From today henceforth, your enemies will not see a better tomorrow. From today henceforth, your enemies will die in garnishings. They shall snatch their teeth in and out. Agony shall be their portion. Tears shall be their breakfast. Sadness shall be their lunch. Disgrace shall be their supper. From today till the day they die, in the mighty name of Jesus, I prophesy over your enemies that they will never see a better days in the rest of their life. I prophesy over your enemies, they will never see a better days in their life. I prophesy over your enemies that the Lord shall disgrace them. They shall give themselves in place of you. They shall give themselves in donation over you. They shall give themselves in place of you. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Any man or woman, any evil child, be it my generation, be it from my foundation, be it from my village, be it from my lineage, be it from the church, be it from my work, be it from wherever, may the arrow of the Lord strike them dead in the name of Jesus. May the arrow of the Lord strike them dead in the name of Jesus. May the arrow of the Lord strike them dead in the name of Jesus. Every evil person that is sitting on your prosperity, every evil person that is sitting on your wealth, every evil person that is sitting on your breakthrough, every evil person that is sitting on your promotion. You have worked for years. You have tarried for years. You have worked like a donkey. From Monday to Sunday, you are working. But you cannot yield result. From January to December, you are working. But you cannot buy a car. But you cannot build a house. Why? Because the enemies are attacking your finances. Because the enemies are sitting on your breakthrough. Because the enemies are sitting on your blessings. But from today henceforth, I remove your enemies from your fortunes in the name of Jesus. From today henceforth, I put my hand in the heavenly places. And I remove your enemies from that seat in the name of Jesus. From today henceforth, I put my anointed hands. And I push your enemies down to the ground in the mighty name of Jesus. I say from today henceforth, you will die on the ground where the Lord has put you. You will not arise again to afflict the children of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Every object, every evil object that comes in disguise, may the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Every evil woman that has turned herself into an animal, that has turned herself into a vulture, that has turned herself into a bird, that has turned herself into a dog, May she never return to a human being again. As she changes herself into angry faces, may the Lord allow her to remain in her angry face. As she turns herself into any object, may she remain in that object in the name of Jesus. As she turns herself into failure, may she remain in her failure in the name of Jesus. Every evil object that is walking when you are sleeping, either mistaken. Every evil object that is walking in your life whilst you're sleeping, may the Lord disgrace them. May the Lord disgrace them. May they transform and never return into their lives again in the mighty name of Jesus. The next time they transform, may they never return into their body again in the mighty name of Jesus. The next time they transform themselves into something, may they never return into their bodies again in the mighty name of Jesus. The next time they will transform themselves into something, may they never return into their bodies again in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil person that is carrying your name, every evil person that is carrying your passport, that is carrying your picture. Some of you, you gave somebody your clothes. They now use your clothes to fight you spiritually. Some of you, you gave someone your hair. They now use your hair to fight you spiritually. Some of you, you just dashed someone your earring because you wanted to do good. And today, they use your earring to fight you. Any man or woman that has used the money you gave them, that has used the clothes you gave them, that is holding on to anything that belongs to you, spiritually or physically, may the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. Whoever took your body parts, be it your underwear, be it your bra, be it your boxer, be it your shirt, be it your shoes, be it your gown, be it your anything that represents you, and they carried it, they got into your house, they got into your car, they got into the other thing, and they paid the thing that belongs to you. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord kill them in the name of Jesus. May they not wake up from their evil in the name of Jesus. May the Lord, I release the thunder fire of the Lord on their lips right now, that the Lord will allow them to confess and die in the name of Jesus. Your enemies must confess and die in the name of Jesus. Your enemies must confess and die in the name of Jesus. Your enemies must confess and die in the name of Jesus. Your enemies must confess and die in the name of Jesus. Your enemies must confess and die in the name of Jesus. Your enemies must confess and die in the name of Jesus. Anybody who picked the sand from your leg, either mistake. Anybody that picked the sand from your leg, anybody that took the food from your house and took it to the oven and kept it at their oven, and they begin to manipulate you, and you can no longer provide for yourself, you can no longer pay the school fee of your children, you can no longer do your breakthrough, you can no longer do the things you used to do. May the fire of your Almighty God locate them today in the name of Jesus. May the fire of your Holy Ghost locate them today in the name of Jesus. May the fire of your Holy Ghost locate them today in the name of Jesus. May the fire of your Holy Ghost locate them in the name of Jesus. May the fire of your Holy Ghost locate them in the name of Jesus. May the fire of your Holy Ghost locate them in the name of Jesus. May the fire of the Holy Ghost locate them in the name of Jesus. May the fire of the Holy Ghost locate them in the name of Jesus. May the fire of the Holy Ghost locate them in the name of Jesus. May the fire of the Holy Ghost locate them in the name of Jesus. Any woman, any man, any child that was born from a woman, who is the reason why my life is like this? Who is the reason why I cannot get to my God-given destiny? Who is the reason why my glory is hanging? Any man or woman that is responsible, any child from the pit of hell that is responsible, fire of the Holy Ghost, kill them today. 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 Ida masake. Ida masake. Somebody you did not understand. Some of you, you don't know. Some of you, you don't know. Some of you, you don't understand. Some of you, you don't understand. If the Lord can open your spiritual eyes at this time for you to know what God is doing, if the Lord can open your spiritual eyes for you to know what the Lord is doing right now, if the Lord can open your spiritual eyes for you to know the battle that God is fighting for you right now. If you know what God is doing right now, if you know what God is doing right now, if you know the battle that the Lord is fighting right now, you will open your mouth and pray. You will drop everything that you're doing and pray like a madman. You will pray like a madwoman. The Bible says that a closed mouth is a closed destiny. You have to pray yourself out. You must pray yourself out. You must pray yourself out. You do not hear me. I said there is somebody. There is somebody. There is somebody. There is somebody here. You just wash your undies in a public compound. You wash your underwear. You wash your clothes. You wash your socks. You went and hung it. And they carried it. And they went to their coven. And you begin to suffer. You begin to suffer. You begin to suffer. Eternal heat. Things begin to come from your body. When you go to pee, you begin to see things come down. You don't feel good in your body. You see the people afflicting you. You see the people manipulating you. You go to Africa. You send money to people in Africa. You send things to people in Africa. You favor people in Africa. You gave your money to people in Africa. You ate with people in Africa. Then they begin to afflict you. They say no better thing shall follow you. That as you come back to Europe, as you come back abroad, that you will suffer. That you will not know better days. That sickness shall locate you. That breakthrough will not be your portion. That the Lord shall disgrace you. Child of God, if you know how to release an amen, release an amen. If you know how to release an amen, release an amen. Let your enemies die. 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 Let them die. Let them die. Let them die in the name of Jesus. It is not every day. It is not every day that I do this. But when I am led by the Spirit, and He says to me, today I want you to go and pray. Today I want you to go and pray for my children. Today I just want you to go and pray for my children. I want you to go and pray because I want to use the prayer to do something. Go and pray. You have been saved for so long. You have been so afflicted. You have been so afflicted in your body. They took something from you and they seized your menstrual cycle. They took something from you and that has caused you from not conceiving. They took something from you and that is the reason why you are having low sperm count. They took something from you. That is the reason why you are not productive. They took something from you. That is why you cannot bear your own children. They took something from you. That is why you can only give birth through IVF. They took something from you. That is why it was not the doctor's fault for them to took out that tube. It was a plan of the enemies. As soon as one tube was gone, the other tube is blocked. You are just walking like that. You can no longer conceive. Your tube is blocked. Your tube is blocked. You are a man. They took something from you, from your dream. That is why you are having low sperm count. That is why you cannot get any woman impregnated. That is why no woman has been impregnated by you. That is why nobody has ever gotten pregnant for you. It is the trick of the devil. Today you are going to pray yourself out. Every evil thing that left my body, that I cannot be productive, that I cannot bear fruit of my own, that I cannot give birth of my own. God of awesome wonders, God of vengeance, God of enough is enough. Return every part of my body. Every part of my body that was stolen by the enemies. Father of the Most High God, return the parts of my body. Every part of my body that was stolen from my enemies. Return every part of my body in the name of Jesus. Every low sperm count, I reverse it in the name of Jesus. Every no menses, I reverse it in the name of Jesus. Every blocked tube, I reverse it in the name of Jesus. Every IVF procedure, I reverse it in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of sight, I reverse it in the name of Jesus. They took something from you. Whilst you were sleeping and you saw people chasing you in your dream, you did not understand why they were chasing you in your dream. While you were sleeping, you did not understand why they were afflicting you in your dream. You did not understand why they were afflicting you in your dream. You did not understand why they were afflicting you. You did not understand why they were afflicting you in your dream. And you woke up from the dream life. And you begin to suffer so many things. And you begin to wonder and you are asking yourself, what happened to me? Why is my life not the same? After this dream I had, my life has never been the same. What is going on with me? After I had this dream, my life is not the same. What happened to me? I can no longer understand myself. After I had this dream, things are not working for me. After I had that dream, after I had that encounter, my life is not in order anymore. After I had that evil encounter, things have started not working for me. Any evil man or woman that is sitting in your destiny, every evil woman, that is the reason why things are not working for you. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord disgrace Jesus. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Every evil man that took anybody part of mine and went to their coven, may the Lord disgrace them. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil story that happened in the life of my parents, every evil reputation in my generation that has been happening to my people. They say in my family it is like that. In my family they die at the age of 50. In my family nobody has been married. In my family nobody can bear fruit. In my family nobody can conceive. In my family there can be no open doors. In my family nobody shall spring forth. By the fire of the Holy Ghost now, every repetition story is not my portion. Whatever was happening to my family is not permitted to happen to me. Whatever was happening in the history of my family is not permitted to happen to me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, every evil story, every evil occurrences, every evil covenant, every blood spilled, every evil covenant in my family, in my generation, in my lineage, in my community, it is not permitted to repeat in myself in the mighty name of Jesus. It's not permitted to repeat itself in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't care what has been happening to the people. I don't care what has been happening to my uncles. I don't care what has been happening to my aunties. I don't care what has been happening to my generation. But I stand with the power of the Holy Ghost today. And I declare and I decree, whatever is not of God cannot happen in my life. Any evil thing that was happening in my parents' generation, that was happening in my lineage, that was happening in my village, that was happening in my church, that was happening to my siblings, it is not my portion. It is not my portion. I covenant myself out. I covenant myself out. Today I pray my way out. Today I pray my way out. Today I redeem myself with the covenant of the Lord, with the blood of the Lamb. Today I stand out. I said it is not my portion. Ida raba seke ya. Ida raba seke ya. Hika baba boseke de boske ya. Ramadi baba seke boske. Rapada baba shete de boske ya. Ramadi da baseke boske. You're gonna tell the Lord something. You gotta learn to pray your way out. You gotta learn to pray your way out and defeat your enemy. The Bible says that this kind cannot pass away except through prayer and fasting. So when you are lying down, sleeping and resting, your enemies are not resting. Every evil covenant, Lord, that I got into, every evil handwriting that was written in my generation, writing that is knocking on the door of my generation, every evil person that is attacking my dream life, that was assigned, the one that I was dedicated to when I was born and I did not know because nobody told me, the one that they covenanted me to, knowingly or unknowingly. Father, today I break forth from every covenant that is not of God in the name of Jesus. Today I break forth from every covenant that is not of God in the name of Jesus. Every covenant that is not of God, every covenant in the shrine, every covenant in the chief priest, every covenant in the covenant of the places that I did not know, anything that I was sold to, today, Lord, I redeem myself with the precious blood of the Lamb. Today, I redeem myself out. I carve myself out from this loss. I carve myself out from this law. I demarcate myself from the laws of men. And I believe that it is the law of the Lord that will walk in my life. Every evil covenant that my parents made, that they had with the devil, that they had with the juju priest, that they did at the shrine, like they did at the market square, that they did at the river, wherever it was done. Father, today I cancel it on my behalf in the name of Jesus. Today I stand and I cancel it on my behalf. Every evil covenant that was made by the river, that was made by the shrine, that was made at the church, that was made at the market square, that was made at the wherever it was made. But every evil covenant that I know nothing about, that is afflicting my life, an end comes to it today. They would die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. They would die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. They would die by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. Some of you, when your parents were looking for a child was not coming forth, and they were deceived, and they said, come, let us take you to somewhere where you can conceive a child. And because they did not want to die in shame, because they did not want to die in agony, because they did not want to die in disgrace, because they did not want to die in mockery, they followed the people and they went to the marine spirit, and the marine spirit gave them something, and they came and pumped their tummy, and they came and rubbed on their tummy, and they came and kept a mark on their body, or they came and drank it, and they brought forth a child, and you are that child, and that evil covenant is still manipulating you, and that evil covenant is still disturbing your life, and that evil covenant is the reason why things are not working from you. Break forth from it today in the name of Jesus. Release the fire of the Holy Ghost today and say they die by fire. Release the fire of the Holy Ghost today and say they die by fire. Release the fire of the Holy Ghost today and say they die by fire. Every evil covenant that I knew nothing about, every evil covenant that I knew nothing about, that my parents did because of frustration in one way or the other, that is manipulating me today, die by fire, 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 die by fire in the name of Jesus. Some of us, we have an evil mark. Some of us, we have an evil mark. And they call it tribal mark. Ah! Some of us, we have an evil mark. They call it tribal mark. They kept a mark on your body when you were born. They cut you from any part of your body. They kept a sound on your tummy. For the women, they circumcise you. And they begin to take something and rub on you. You don't know what it is they rubbed on you. For the men, they circumcised you. And then they took something and they rubbed on you. You don't know what they rubbed on you. You don't know what covenant they entered into. You don't know what the meaning of what it was. Because you were just a child. Because you were innocent. Because you did not know the limitation. You gotta tell the Lord something now. Every evil thing that they took and put on me when I did not know as a little child, Some of you, they cut off your navel and then they took something and they rub on your navel. When the navel was breaking forth, they took that thing and they rub on your navel. Some people use like water to pump your navel. You don't know what they were pumping into you. You don't know what they were putting into you. They say this one is so that the woman will not be following men. They say this one is so that the man will enjoy sex. This one is so that the woman will enjoy sex. Every evil thing that was done. Every evil thing that was done, every evil thing that was done that you did not know about, that you were innocent, may the Lord remove it in the name of Jesus. Whatever was rubbed on you, whatever was applied on you, whatever was put on you, whatever mark was kept on you, die by the fire of the Holy Ghost. 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 Die by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Everything that was covenanted, you cannot die for what you don't know. You can die for what you don't know. You can die for what you are not guilty of. You don't know what they did. Whatever covenant they entered into, that is totally their own problem. Whatever covenant they entered into, that is totally your own problem, not your own. Now you are going to tell the Lord, every evil money that they use in selling me, Idamaseke. Some of you, they have sold your destiny. Some of you, they have sold your future. Some of you, they have sold your breakthrough. Some of you, they have sold your deliverance. Some of you, they have sold your prosperity. Some of you, they have sold your breakthroughs. Some of you, they have sold your luck. And that is why you're walking empty in this life. You are just walking empty. Nothing is happening for you. Nothing is happening to you. Nothing is happening by you. And nothing is happening with you. You begin to roam around the surface of the earth like that. You begin to roam around the surface of the earth like that. You begin to roam around the surface of the earth like that. Why? Because you don't know what they did. Why? Because you don't know what you were sold to. Why? Because you don't know what the enemies did. Why? Because you don't know the affliction of the enemy. You did not know the repercussion. Everything that you did not know about. You cannot enter into a covenant that you don't know. You cannot go into an agreement when you are innocent. Whatever it is that they did. Whatever it is that they called your name, wherever it is that they pour libation, whatever it is that they pour libation, today I stand by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every libation that was poured, today I use the blood of Jesus, and I also pour the same libation in the name of God the Father. I pour the same libation in the name of God the Son. I pour the same libation in the name of God the Holy Spirit. I erase every covenant that was made on your behalf, negatively in the name of Jesus. I erase every evil money that was used in buying you, buying your future, buying your destiny, buying your breakthrough, buying your deliverance, buying your glory, buying the grace that God gave you. Today, I destroy it in the name of Jesus. Today, I destroy it in the name of Jesus. Today, I destroy it in the name of Jesus. Today I destroy it in the name of Jesus. Today I destroy it in the name of Jesus. Today I destroy it in the name of Jesus. Today I destroy it in the name of Jesus. I use this once as a point of contact to reach out to anyone that has applied for citizenship. Anybody that has been in a country for so long and you have applied for citizenship and you are not able to get your citizenship. Today, as I anoint all of these documents, yours will come forth in the name of Jesus. Yours will come through in the name of Jesus. As you go to send your document, as you go to submit your document, the face of the Lord shall speak for you. As soon as they see your document, it shall be accepted in the name of Jesus. It shall be accepted in the name of Jesus. Every evil plan of the enemy for you not to get your document in the country where you are today, as the blood of Jesus goes on this document for the ones that has this one, the same thing goes for you. As I anoint this document for the ones, I use this one as a point of contact to reach out to anybody that has his or her application to go citizenship, any form of document. God did it for somebody yesterday, and the person testifies and says, I have received my document, the plastic copy, just like the Lord said. Everything came in a smell. The same thing shall happen to you. The same thing shall happen to you. The same thing shall happen to you in the mighty name of Jesus. As they set their eyes on the document, as they set their eyes on the document, there shall be no word from them. There shall be no complaint from them. All they will be saying is congratulations. It will come faster than you ever expected in the mighty name of Jesus. I use these documents, Lord, as a point of contact for everyone that is going through the same thing, Lord. It needs your breakthrough power. Lord, may the same happen to them in the mighty name of Jesus. May the same be done unto others in the name of Jesus. For as many that are believing you for their breakthrough, Lord, may they come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. May they come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. May they come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. May they come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. May they come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. May they come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. May they come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. May they come back in a testimony in the name of Jesus. I approve all of your documents right now in the name of Jesus. I approve all of your documents right now. Any document, any court case, any visa, any application, any admission, any contract, anything that you have ever put into application and you want the Lord to see you through, it is hereby approved in the mighty name of Jesus. It is hereby approved in the mighty name of Jesus. It is hereby approved in the mighty name of Jesus. I release divine speed. I release divine speed. I release divine speed. I release divine speed. Speed of the Most High God. Heavenly speed. Breakthrough speed. That the Lord will allow everything that you have applied for to come to pass for you in the name of Jesus. Every date that has stood, every debt that has stood in your life, receive the grace for debt cancellation in the name of Jesus. Receive the debt cancellation in the name of Jesus. Every debt that you apply for, and you want to do something, may it be released unto you in the name of Jesus. I see so many people being denied for house loan. I see so many people being denied for car loans. I see so many people being denied of student loan. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. 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 Every marriage that has been pending, every marriage that the enemies does not want it to come to pass, every marriage that the enemies does not want you to get into that home, from today henceforth, you will get married. You will be celebrated. You will locate the bone of your bone and the flesh of your flesh. Every evil marriage that is not of God, every marriage that will not bring you peace from the Lord, every marriage that is not of God's plan for you, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. 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 I don't care how far you have gone. I don't care what you have done. I don't care what they have given on your behalf and what they have not given. Any marriage that is not assigned by the Lord Most High for you, may you be destroyed in the name of Jesus. May you be destroyed in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy that marriage that is not of him in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy every marriage that is not of him in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy every evil marriage. Every evil marriage that is not of the Lord, that will not bring you peace, that will not bring you joy, that you will not be happy, that you will not have peace, that you will go in and you will regret. May the Lord destroy it in the name of Jesus. Every evil marriage that is not of the Lord, every evil marriage that the enemies want to use to fight your destiny, for glory, to fight God's success. May the Lord destroy it in the name of Jesus. I say you shall not stand, neither will it come to pass. Any evil marriage that is not of God is hereby canceled. Is hereby canceled. Is hereby canceled. Is hereby canceled. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil marriage. Every evil marriage. Because the only thing that the enemy is used to fight the children of God is true marriage. May the Lord help you not to make mistake in marriage. A mistake in marriage is a mistake of a lifetime. One mistake in marriage is a mistake of your future. One mistake in marriage is a mistake of your destiny. One mistake in marriage is a mistake that you are ruined for your lifetime. Ah, those who have made mistake in marriage, they wish that they can go back to correct the hands of time. If you are single and you are under the sound of my voice right now, embrace the opportunity to wait for God. If you are single and you are under the sound of my voice right now, embrace the grace to wait for God in marriage. Because a mistake made in marriage is a mistake of your destiny. Every evil marriage that is not of God, every evil relationship that will not bring glory to you, that will not bring honor to your creator, that will not allow you to reach the divine purpose that God has kept for you. Any man or woman that is not for you, and you are forcing yourself to that man or woman, may the Lord destroy it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy that marriage in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy that marriage in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy that relationship in the name of Jesus. Any man or woman that is not for you. Any man or woman that is not for you. Any man or woman that is not for you. Any man or woman that will not bring you good luck. That will not allow the divine purpose of God to be fulfilled in your life. May the Lord cancel them. May the Lord take them away. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. From today henceforth, I put my hand in the heavenly place. And I call forth the bones of your bones. I call forth the flesh of your flesh. I call forth your destiny wives from the north, from the east, from the south, from the west. I call forth your destiny husbands from the north, from the east, from the south, from the west. I call forth your divine partners from wherever they are in any part of the world. That they should locate you in the name of Jesus. That they should locate you in the name of Jesus. That they should locate you in the name of Jesus. Any marriage, any relationship that will not lead you on your fruit, may the Lord scatter in the name of Jesus. Any woman or man that wants to use marriage to destroy your destiny, that wants to use marriage to quit your destiny, that wants to use marriage to get to his promised land, the Lord sees the utmost heart of a man. The Lord sees the utmost heart of a woman. We only see the outside. Everyone that does not have right intention for us, anyone that does not mean well for us, anyone that does not have better plan for us, and they came to disgrace us, and they came to disappoint us, and they came to lie to us, may the Lord punish them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord disgrace them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy them in the name of Jesus. May the fire of the Lord locate them in the name of Jesus. May shame be their portion in the name of Jesus. May the Lord give them desires that they never expected from the Lord in the name of Jesus. Any man or woman who came to the life of a Christian, who came to the life of a child of God to bring disgrace to you, to bring shame to you, to bring humiliation to you, but from the beginning, they did not have any better plan for you. May the Lord destroy them in Jesus' name. May the Lord destroy them in Jesus' name. May the Lord destroy them in Jesus' name. Every evil relationship, every evil marriage intention, every engagement that is not of the Lord, I scatter it in the name of Jesus. Every engagement that is not of the Lord, I scatter in the name of Jesus. Every marriage proposal that is not of the Lord, I scatter it in the name of Jesus. Every marriage ceremony that is not of the Lord, it shall not hold in the name of Jesus. Every evil intention in the heart of men, for you not to meet God's given destiny, for you not to reach your God's given talent, for you not to be that person that God has built you to be, may the Lord destroy it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord destroy it in the name of Jesus. I don't care how you want to die for what you are holding on to. I don't want to know how long it has gone. I don't want to know whether they have paid their bride price. I don't want to know whether they have fixed the date. I don't want to know what you are doing. Whatever is not of the Lord of God in your life, whatever is not of the Lord in your life, may you be scattered in the name of Jesus. May you be scattered in the name of Jesus. May you be scattered in the name of Jesus. May you be scattered in the name of Jesus. There is no plan on earth that will stand in your life except the plan of the Lord. There is no other plan in their lives that will stand except the plan of the Lord. The Lord says, except he builds the house, that the people builds but in vain. Except he watches over the city, he says the watchman watches but in vain. Right now, with the fire of the Lord that is upon my life, with the grace of God that is upon my life, I begin to speak into every situation. I say, any marriage on earth that is not of God, every marriage that is not God's desire for you, may it scatter in the name of Jesus. Every marriage that is not of God, may it scatter in the name of Jesus. Every marriage that is not of God, I repeat, may it scatter in the name of Jesus. Any marriage that is not of God, it will not stand, neither will it come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Any marriage that is not God's divine purpose for you, any marriage that will not allow you to reach your destiny land, any marriage that will not allow you to achieve and receive what God has in store for you, may that marriage scatter in the name of Jesus. May that marriage scatter in the name of Jesus. May that marriage scatter in the name of Jesus. Every proposal that is not of God, every arrangement to be married this year, next week, that's one. If it is not the will of God, may it scatter in the name of Jesus. Every marital settlement, every relationship, every marital settlement, every relationship that is not of God for you, that you will not be happy in it, that you will not spring forth results, that prosperity will not spring forth from it, that you will regret in future, may the Lord cancel it today. In the mighty name of Jesus, the wise one says, a broken relationship is better than a broken marriage. Let the will of God be done among the wills of men. Let the will of God be done above the wills of men. Let the will of God be done above the wills of men. Whatever is not of God is not permitted to stand. Every marriage in your life that is not of God, may ye scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. Every marriage that is not of God, may ye scatter in the name of Jesus. Every marriage that is not of God, I say, may ye scatter in the name of Jesus. Every marriage that the Lord has not assigned, that will not lead you to your promised land. A marriage that you will regret tomorrow. A marriage that you will put your hand on your head tomorrow. A marriage that you will not have joy in. A marriage that the beginning is so good, but the ending will not be good. May the Lord cancel it for you in the name of Jesus. May the Lord scatter it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord scatter it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord scatter it in the name of Jesus. Every proposal, every engagement, every cutting period that is not of the Lord, may the Lord cancel it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord cancel it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord cancel it in the name of Jesus. May the Lord cancel it in the name of Jesus. You will not get it wrong in marriage. You will not marry wrongly, because marriage is your destiny. You will not get it marriage. Because when you get it wrong in marriage, you are destroyed for the rest of your life. You will not make mistakes in marriage. You will not marry the wrong person. You will not end up with a deceiver in the name of marriage. The Bible makes us to understand it is not everything that looks like it that is it. People pretend well. Tell God that let his will be done. Let the will of God alone be done in your marriages. Let the will of God alone be done in your relationship. Let the will of God be done in every area of your life. Let the will of God be done in everything that you do. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Today I came for us to pray. Today I came for us to pray. And the moment I came on till now, I have been praying for 2 hours. It is 2 hours of prayer. I came for us to pray aggressively. It is not every day that I do this. But when my father says, go and do it, I just go and do it. We were hosting a watch party. And I canceled the watch party. And I said, it is time to come line. Because I am coming to pray. I just started the video. Join me and pray. Join me and pray is what I tapped the video and I released fire. If you have missed this broadcast, I'm sorry for you. It was our day of vengeance. It was our day of enough is enough. It was our day of violent prayer, aggressive prayer. That was what I had. I thank the Lord that Esther has bought the phone. More aggressive prayers will be coming on the audio. More aggressive fires will be coming on the audio. I am a praying woman. I love to pray. I am a kingdom woman. I love to pray. I know how to do the work of my father when I want to do. If you have prayed that prayer with me, don't allow the devil to use you. After we have finished this prayer, begin to sow a seed for your prayer. Begin to seal it. Give an offering for this prayer that you pray today. I got some people soon entering. I'm just going to quickly pray. Seal your prayer so that it will happen. It is not every day that such prayer comes forth. So when we have a prayer like this, you must seal it and say, Father, I know that I have received. For my received blessing, for the things are. Even if you have come to meet me for counseling, probably I will not dig that file like that. I touch everything in your life negatively. From your dream life to your jobs, to your promotion, to your marriage, to everything in this life, I touch it in this prayer. Send this prayer to your friends. If you have never shared a video, share your video to your friend. Or you're going to share this video. Send it to your family. Let them use it and pray. If somebody prays this aggressive prayer that we have prayed, and the person still stays in bondage, they know that it is not God that I'm saving. Your enemies, you cannot say this prayer and your enemies remains alive. You will hear people's death. You will hear people's confession. You will see people that will not even talk to you. It was a move of the Holy Spirit. It was the Holy Spirit that did it. Documents were released. Things were done. Don't allow your hand to lack. Seal your prayer up with a seed. Make sure that you seal your prayer. It is not every day that this happens. Seal your prayer and take it. Because if you were going to meet a prophet to counsel you, you will sow. Debt cancellation, loan. There is nothing that was not covered on this prayer. Save this prayer. Save it. And any day that you feel like praying, listen to it at night before you sleep. You will never sleep. You will never have those bad dreams. That is why I want to make the video short. I want to make it just 2 hours so that you can play it, reminisce on it, speak into your life, use it and do your prayer. Host a watch party with it. Let people pray with you. And I'm not going to do anything than just pray in this track so that people can use it to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for a day like this, for a time like this. I worship you because you are God all by yourself. Father, I bring my seed before you and the seed of your children. I say, Lord, whatever it is that people use money to buy from us, Today, Lord, we have prayed ourselves out. And we have also used a seed, Lord, to seal our blessing. Father, affliction will never arise again the second time. Wherever our enemies will arise from, Lord, they will meet with the fire of the Holy Ghost. Father, we release the fire of the Holy Ghost upon our lives, our dwellings, our everything, our children, whatever we call our names after and before. Lord, we release the same grace, Lord, as we have sealed our prayer. This prayer shall locate us all the days of our lives. In our going out and our coming in, Lord, we shall be blessed all round. The devil does not have any place again. Whatever was stolen from us, Lord, has been revived. You said it's enough, it's enough. You said vengeance, time for you to avenge. Father, thank you for your vengeance is here. Thank you for enough is enough. We are victorious. We will break forth. We will celebrate and we will spring forth. And Lord, I release testimonies in the atmosphere that your children will testify over this prayer in the name of Jesus. People shall remember this day, Lord, and they will live to honor your name forever. Thank you, mighty Jesus, for what you've done. I cover all our prayer requests with the precious blood of the Lamb, Lord, that no devil will be able to steal our prayer, that nothing shall touch our prayer. I release your arrow over every prayer point that we pray. I release the flaming fire of the Holy Ghost over every prayer that we pray, Lord, that whatever it is that is not of you, Lord, is not permitted to stand, neither will it come near our dwelling place. Father, take preeminence, take control, take dominion over every area of our lives, and whatever we will do, let your name, let your honor, let your blessings, let your majesty, let your grace and mercy locate us now until the hours of our death. In the mighty name of Jesus, our blessings are permanent, and so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. To every sower, to every seeder, to everyone that donated offering, you are blessed. I bless you in your finances. I bless you in your going out and your coming in. And I rebuke the devourer for your sake, that there shall be no devourer for your sake in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I pray for every Heaven Chapel Titus. Every Titus in Heaven Chapel, Lord. I cover their finances with the precious blood of the Lord, Lamb. That you will continue to provide for them, Lord. For their sake, protocol shall be broken. The devourer shall not come near their dwelling place in any kind. Sickness, breakdown, everything that they will spend miscellaneously is hereby cancelled in the mighty name of Jesus. They shall not spend money miscellaneously in Jesus' mighty name. Their finances are protected. Their health are protected. Everything, whatever you have done in the land of Heaven Chapel, that's exactly what happens in their life. I bless you for the lives of this one. I bless you for allowing them to be faithful, because the word says, as a man robbed God, say yes in tithe and in offering. That's where we rob the Lord. But Lord, may you continue to teach your children the truth so that it might be well with us and we can reap bountifully from you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Okay, so at the end of this prayer, I'm quickly going to bless water. If you have water, let me bless your water for you. If you have water in the service, can you go ahead and type, I have my water. If you have water in the service, can you go ahead and type, I have my water. I want to quickly bless water before I go. I want to quickly bless water before I go. Be very quick. Be very quick. Be very quick. Otherwise, I leave it and I bless it tomorrow. But you know, when the prayer is this powerful, it is always good to just bless. When the prayer is really powerful, it is always good to just bless people. The water that I'm going to bless for you will speak for you in every area of your life. The water that I'm going to bless for you today will speak for you in every area of your life. So if you have water and you want me to bless it for you, go ahead and let me bless it for you. If you have water, just say, I have my water. Go ahead. Be very fast. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the life of your children. Father, for every prayer that you have answered today, I thank you. Father, for everything that you have done, Father, I give you glory.
Father, for the gracious deeds that you have done. Ah, Father, I see a bright future ahead of your children. Father, today we did not just come because we feel like coming. Today we came to pray and seek heaven for our sake. Father, today we came to pray and seek heaven for our sake. I bless water for your children in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I turn this water to become the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. The blood of Jesus that cleanses us of every unrighteousness. The blood of Jesus that cleanses us from every iniquity. The blood of Jesus that knows the secret things of the kingdom. Father, let your blood speak for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your blood speak for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your blood speak for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your blood speak for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your blood speak for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, today I leave the blood in your mighty hands. That whatever your children will leave the blood to do, whatever your children will be led by the blood to do, whatever your children will use the blood to do, Lord, may it come to pass for them speedily in the name of Jesus. For those that wants to anoint their body if they are sick, for those that wants to drink for breakthrough, for those that wants to use it for signs and wonders. Father, it is not limited to anything. It is rather open to everything. Father, because of the blood, doors shall open. Father, because of the blood, marriages shall spring forth. Father, because of the blood, people shall get their wisdom back in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, because of the blood, the brains of your children shall be revived. Father, because of the blood, the people in their life shall be blood. Father, because of the blood, the revival will rekindle in the life of your children. Father, today, Lord, even in the lives of our children, may the blood speak for us. Even in our businesses, may the blood speak for us. Even in our breakthrough, Lord, may the blood speak for us. Whatever we would do, Lord, may the blood speak for us. May the blood be for us. May the blood stand for us in every area of our life. Father, I release testimonies through the power that is in your blood, that people would testify. Father, prove yourself that your children would know that you are God. Thank you because you have never failed. I obeyed you and I did as you commanded. May your name be highly exalted. May all the glory, all the honor, and all the adoration, which no man on earth can ever have, may it be ascribed unto you alone. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Drink. God bless us, God bless us, God bless us, God bless us, God bless us. So I'm going to be continuing with the watch party. I just came on for us to pray. Today I just wanted us to pray. Today I just wanted us to pray. We have been on for 2 hours, 13 minutes and 55 seconds. I just came on for us to pray. I just felt the Lord told me to come and pray. He said, go and pray with my children. Go and pray. That's why I came for us to pray. Today, I just came for us to pray. You know, there is that time in your life that you need to get aggressive in your spirit. There is that time in your life you need to put on your praying garments. There is that time in your life you gotta say enough is enough. There is that time in your life you got to kick the devil out in the face so hard. There is that time in your life you got to pray a violent prayer, an aggressive prayer. There is that time in your life you got to tell the devil that you are a bastard. You are the reason why I'm sitting on the floor. Why will I allow you to continue to let me cry? There is that time in your life when you begin to let the devil know that he's a bastard. There is that time in your life when you want to let the devil know that he's an idiot. There is that time in your life you just want to let the devil know that he's a failure. You just want him to know that he's a loser. You just want to know, let him know that he's a manipulator and he cannot manipulate you. There is that time you want to let the devil know that he was defeated years back. So how come he's still coming to reign? He is not the reigning king. The reigning king is in heaven and he got no damn power to do nothing. There is that time you gotta get up and pray your way out and tell the devil, look at me. I have been quiet for so long. You gotta pack your load and leave my house. I got no room for you anymore. I got no patience with you anymore. You gotta keep going like right now. There is that time you gotta open the door and walk the devil out of your house. There is that time you gotta tell the devil that you know something, you are an idiot. In fact, I have been so dumb to allow you manipulate me this way. Now I am ready for you. Let us fight it, power to power, and see who is the winner. Because I have never heard them sing, Satan is. I only heard, Jesus is a winner man all the time. Oh, Jesus is a winner man. Jesus is a winner man. Jesus is a winner man. A winner man all the time. Oh, yes. A winner man, a winner man, a winner man. A winner man, a winner man, a winner man. A winner man, a winner man, a winner man. A winner man all the time. How about Satan? Satan is a loser man. Satan is a stupid man. Satan is a loser man. A loser man all the time. Oh, yes. He's a loser man, a loser man, a loser man. A loser man, a loser man, a loser man. A loser man, a loser man, a loser man. A loser man all the time. He's a loser. Come on, people of God. The devil is a loser. The devil is a stinking bastard. God punish devil. You must curse the devil in the morning. Curse the devil in the afternoon. Curse the devil at night time. Tell the devil you are a bastard. You are an idiot. You are smelling. You are a coward. That is why you cannot come in the physical. That is why the devil fights in the spiritual. Because he's a coward. Because he's a fool. Because he's an idiot. So you must let the devil know where he belongs. Stop giving glory to the devil. Fight the devil. Attack the devil. Stand up for your right. The devil is just an hungry bastard. The devil is the devourer that is looking for who to devour. The devil is the reason for your problem. Don't spare the devil. Don't do gentleman with the devil. Don't do gentle lady with the lady. The devil does not know gentleness. He's a loser. The word loser in cap is what the devil is. He's an idiot. He's a bastard. He has never won one single battle since I was born. And now I am getting old. I have never seen the devil win one battle. On the cross, he failed. In my health, he failed. In my ministry, he failed. In my family, he failed. In every area of my life, the devil has failed. So I don't believe that the devil exists. That is why I am out to fight the devil. My whole mission of the ministry is to fight the devil. I am out for the devil. Because the devil does not have any right. The devil is an idiot. You are the one who has a better stand than the devil. Because God does not recognize the devil. But God recognized you. God does not love the devil. God loves you. So the devil is a stranded fool. The devil is an idiot. He's a loser. God does not recognize the devil. God recognizes you. God recognizes me. Why? Because we are little gods. The devil belongs to the pit. The devil belongs to the pit. That's where he belongs, to the pit. So pit him there. Don't open the doors of your house for the devil. Don't allow the devil to come to your living room and sit on your couch, because he should not even be worthy to live in your bush. Kick the devil. Kick the devil out of your life. Don't spare him. In the morning when you wake up, tell him, Satan, shame unto you. All power belongs to God. You are a thief. The devil is the thief of your destiny. The devil is the thief of your marriage, the thief of your children, the thief of your breakthrough, the thief of your promotion, the thief of your visa, the thief of your document, the thief of your employment, the thief of your happiness. The devil is nothing but a thief. He does not come except to kill, to steal, and to destroy. So when the devil is destroying you and you keep quiet, he will kill you. When the devil is stealing, you keep quiet, it will destroy you. When he destroys you, you keep quiet, the devil will kill you, because this is his mission. This is the only mission the devil has. So you too must get a mission. The devil has got a mission, go get a mission. Don't allow the devil to use you and play lullaby. Don't allow the devil to use you and play Ludo. Don't allow the devil to use you and play ping pong. You are bigger than that. Okay? You are bigger than that. May the Lord bless us. I'm going to continue to host the watch party from New Jersey. I will continue to host the watch party from New Jersey. And I will see you tomorrow. Keep the faith up. You cannot be afraid of the arrow that flies by the day, nor the one that flies by the night. Because the Lord guard you. You're not going to be afraid of them. They got no power. There is no prayer point that I did not touch today. Every moving object, every moving object that turns themselves into something and flies at night and manipulates your destiny, that is fire. Today, the Lord has given all of your tears, all of your agonies, all of your anger, all of your disappointment, everything that was on your head, today the devil carries it. Next time the devil will not come and be born, because you have afflicted the devil with everything. You see, today when they were coming, I was not even minding them, because I was in a different realm. The Lord says, go and cast them, leave them to me. I was not minding them. I was so in the realm of the spirit that I refused to see them, because I know where they belong. Sometimes you just put them where they belong. When you run curses on them, that curses will locate them for the rest of their lives. And they will know that, I will not forget where I was cursed. Bastardly. My people, it is good to be spiritual. Keep your spiritual life alert. Keep your spiritual life what? Alert. If you want to sly and slay, you sly or you slay. When you sly and slay, make sure you sly and you slay in the Lord. When you are slying and slaying, make sure that you are slying and slaying in the Lord. Get that life comes, blow you. May the coverage that is upon my life speak for you in the name of Jesus. May the grace that is upon my life speak for you at all times in the name of Jesus. May the grace, the mantle that the Lord gave to me, speak over your lives in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you. I'm just gonna let us go, and tomorrow we are going to be coming live. Tomorrow, by the grace of God. Tomorrow, by the grace of God, we'll be coming live and we'll stay longer than now. I'm going to fix some things. Ushers, please get me on the phone as soon as I'm done. The only person I see ushering for me is Kaline. Kaline, I bless you in the name of God the Father. I bless you in the name of God the Son. Bless you in the name of God, the Holy Spirit. Thank you for ushering with me to the end. May the Lord fulfill all the desires of your heart, even the exams that you're reading for. May the Lord give you victory from today's prayer, that you will remember this prayer in your life in the name of Jesus. So tomorrow we'll be meeting. As soon as I'm done with the meeting, get me all the ushers online. I need to have a quick meeting with you guys Tomorrow I'll be coming live and we'll talk. When I come live tomorrow, we'll stay for long. I'm going to continue hosting the New Jersey program. Please, I want you to join the New Jersey watch party, especially that mantle service. As I'm giving that mantle out to people, key into it. If you have a cloth in your house, if you have an handkerchief in your house, if you have a scarf in your house, use it. Key into that mantle and bless your own mantle. For those of you who don't know how to use that mantle, let the mantle never disappear from your neck. For those of you who keep having nightmares, if you're using that mantle, you will not be having nightmares. So if you're having bad dreams, you will not be having bad dreams. When I'm hosting that watch party from New Jersey and I'm releasing the mantle and giving people, pick a mantle, pick an handkerchief, anything that represents a mantle. As I bless it, you do the same thing for yourself. It's going to work. And if you so wish to get the mantle, it's still available. If you want to get the mantle, message me and say, Mommy, I need the mantle. How can I get the mantle? Mommy, I need the t-shirt. How can I get the t-shirt? You message me and you will get it. May the good Lord bless you. May all of the blessings that God has given to you abide with you now to the house of our Lord coming. In the mighty name of Jesus, let us share the grace of fellowship together. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord, celebrating forever, forever, in the mighty name of Jesus. You will stay. All the blessings, goodness of the Lord shall locate you. Your life shall never remain the same. God bless you. You know that I love you, and there is nothing you can do about it. I love you with the love of the Lord. There is nothing you can do about it. I got no choice than to love you. Loving you is a choice I made. And my wish above all wishes for you is heaven at last. I wish you heaven at last. Until I come your way again tomorrow, remain blessed. From me to you, be blessed.